Well, we'll see how this works. I'm down at Tramp Harbor, my favorite beach for doing Qigong. And, well, you know, Qigong is kind of like prayer for me. It's a way to connect with nature and with the force behind nature. But I thought you might like to join me. This morning I was thinking about, how can I help in these times? I'm a little over 70, and I've had pneumonia a few times, so I probably shouldn't go out and offer to do errands for people. But maybe I can bring people a little bit of peace in another way. The peace that I feel when I'm doing Qigong down at the beach. Behind me in the parking area, a woman's car died because apparently the battery got used up. And the man from the school district who fixes the school buses came to help her out. So behind me, I'm hearing their voices as they discuss how to keep the car running, what might have caused the battery to stop, and just generally being friendly. Social distancing doesn't keep people from helping each other. And I'm grateful for that. So I'm watching the birds, listening to the crows, hearing the soft sound of the water, and their car drives by. Yesterday, we had a strong north wind, and the waves were much more active, almost like on the seacoast, but not quite. Here on Puget Sound, the waves are far more gentle, if at all. It's funny, when I'm illustrating Seagull's Gift, my picture book for children that I'm working on, I tried painting the sand golden because golden is such a happy color. But the sand here isn't golden. The sand here is kind of gray. How can I make gray be a happy color? Maybe if I focus on the shells. Some driftwood. Now there's a shot. I should photograph that. The big pieces of driftwood. This piece here. This has been here for years. And its shape is kind of like a couch. Makes it really nice to sit on and watch the water and the birds. Sometimes there are 100 or maybe 200 widgeons here, but not today. Sometimes there are, I don't know, 20 or 50 seagulls or crows, but not today. Still, there are a few water birds. Where did they go? Oh, I don't know if you can see them. They're way out there. And there are a few seagulls sitting on the pilings. Some days every piling has a seagull on it. One time the tide was so high that that poor little gray house must have had water less than an inch from the bottom of the floor. Or actually maybe even over the floor because the yard was flooded that day. Thank goodness people can still walk their dogs. I have to tell you, being outside is pretty wonderful. And healthy too. I read last night that during the flu of 1918, doctors found out that putting people outside in the fresh air and sunshine actually helped them to heal faster. They had a better recovery rate. There's something about the very quiet surf. So calming. I'm hoping you can feel that calm. And know that whatever happens, the tides will still go in, come in, and go out. And come in, and go out. There was a time when I was on the edge of nervous breakdown, and watching the tide go out, and come in, and go out, and come in. I think it helped me keep my sanity. I am so grateful for this beach. Well, I think I've had enough calm for today that I can now go back and work in the studio. I'm working on a couple, three projects. My memoir, Patchwork House, about my hippie days living in a ghost town. A picture book, Seagull's Gift, based on a time when a seagull gave me a shell in return for a piece of cheese. I kid you not. I never knew that the birds paid that much attention to us. But she dropped my favorite shell right down beside me. The shell that I had said earlier was my favorite. And I'm working on a backdrop for my husband Rich's booth at Fremont. And hopefully, again, at Saturday Market on Vashon. Well, when the market's open again, it will depict kind of a Mediterranean shop and hopefully help focus on his products. Organic olive oil, used vinegars, and spices and herbs of his own creation and others. Meanwhile, he's more unemployed than I am. For me, working in the studio, I still have trouble focusing on studio work just as much as, maybe more than before. blessings on you, and may you find peace during this day.